small molecules, such as hydrogen iodide. The rate constant from experiments KE is very closely similar to the rate constant from theoretical calculations. However, when we complicated the molecules to ethene, to ethanol with acetic anhydride, the variations went absolutely wild. Let us look back and get an explanation for this. To use E to the minus E over RT for a reaction rate, we assumed that one, molecules behave like rigid spheres. Two, EA is translational in character only. And that when molecules are relatively simple, e.g. that and that, they approximate rigid spheres. Hence, the foregoing theoretical calculation is roughly applicable. Three, for more complex molecules, the rigid sphere approximation is not satisfactory. Accounts must be taken of the translational energy, B, the rotational energy, C, the vibrational energy. Molecules acquire EA through collisions, but this energy must be redistributed properly between the vibrational and rotational translational forms before a reaction occurs. One, the number of collisions is still Z, but E to the minus EA over RT no longer determines the probability that a collision will lead to a reaction. No direct method has been devised to calculate the fraction of fruitful collisions in the general cases of molecules that are not rigid spheres. For these critical orientations of the molecules may be necessary. Hence, the number of effective collisions may be less than that from kinetic theory. Let the fraction of fruitful collisions in this case be P. Hence, K will be Pz e to the minus E over RT. In this case, P is called the steric factor. Hence, P is a measure of the discrepancy between the experimental KR and the theoretical one from collision theory. P has values ranging from nearly unity in hydrogen iodide decomposition to 10 to the minus 5 or as low as 10 to the minus 8. Weaknesses then. Hence, the simple collision theory is inadequate for all but a few gas phase molecules. All attempts to find the theoretical basis for P failed. The P factor could not be correlated with molecular structure and orientation to form activated complex. It was also found that for many unimolecular reactions and the reactions in solution involving ions, the rate is faster than that predicted. Hence, P factor is greater than 1. Again, collision theory cannot offer a satisfactory theory to explain this observation. An essential weakness of the collision theory, or hypothesis, if you may call it that, becomes evident when reversible reactions are considered. For instance, if A2 plus B2 gives you 2AB, where K1 is the forward rate constant and K2 is the reverse rate constant, for the forward reaction, K1 is equal to Z1 e to the minus E over RT, while for the reverse reaction, K2 is equal to Z2 e to the minus E over RT, which implies K1 over K2, which we know always is equal to capital K, is equal to E to the minus EA minus EA1 minus EA2 over RT. Here, of course, we are assuming that Z1 over Z2 is equal to 1. That would imply that K is equal to E to the minus delta H over RT. This is only true at absolute zero, or when the reaction involves no change in entropy, delta S. If P1 and P2 are introduced, then K is equal to K1 over K2, like before, which means P1 Z1 over P2 Z2 e to the minus delta H over T. That is, P1 over P2 involves delta S term. Hence, K1 over K2 is equal to capital K, is now equal to e to the minus delta G naught, double dagger, over RRT. Consequently, K is equal to Z e to the minus delta H, double dagger, over RRT, times e to the minus delta S, double dagger, over R. Recent modifications. Smith, 1982, Journal of Chemical Education, 59, pages 9 to 14. According to Smith, in the collision of a monoatomic or diatomic molecule, A colliding with B to give you C, we have to consider not only the direction of collision, but we also have to look at the angle of the collision. That is, A is colliding with BC. A and BC are still rigid spheres, but BC is a more structured molecule. Now, activation barrier E effective depends on the angle phi as well between molecular axis and the line XY joining the centers of the molecule. So E effective now is equal to E naught plus 2E into 1 minus cos phi. If phi is naught, the activation barrier is a minimum. If phi is 90, the activation barrier is a maximum. That is, collision is more effective if A strikes BC end on or along the BC molecular axis. Hence, collision cross-section is both energy and angle dependent. Both must be accommodated in the calculation of the rate coefficient. 2. Molecules must attain separation D, where capital D is less than little d. D is the sum of the molecular diameters before reaction can take place. This is a recognition of the small reaction distances found in detailed calculations of reaction cross-section. Here, K is equal to KB T over 2E dashed into 8 KB T over pi mu to the 1/2 times pi D squared exponential to the minus E naught over KB T, which goes to K is equal to pi D squared into 8 KB T over pi mu to the 1/2 exponential minus E naught over RT.